Hi, and welcome to yet another new Azure Vlog episode. In this Azure Vlog, we are going to talk about an ASM to ARM migration. Back in the old days, Azure Resource Manager, ARM, didn't exist. In the old days, we worked with ASM, Azure Service Manager. And there were a couple of limitations on Azure Service Manager. For example, there was no role-based access control in it. So Microsoft reinvented Azure and came with the Azure Resource Manager. And now a lot of people have classic VMs, which are actually the ASM VMs, want to get rid of them and get ARM VMs. In this vlog, I will demonstrate to you how we can migrate those ASM VMs to ARM VMs. So let's dive into the matter. There are a couple of ways to do a migration. There are certain tools available like MakeWiz, which will analyze your ASM subscription, and they make an ARM template of it, do a storage copy, and then build up new VMs which are connected to those new storage. In this demonstration, I'm not going to use one of those tools. I'm going to work with the Azure Resource Manager itself. There is actually a resource provider available which will help us to migrate those VMs to ARM. So let's dive in to the technical stuff. What I have over here are three resource groups. One, it's classic networking. I have a classic VNet over here. Here, look, it's VNet 01. I have a classic storage resource group, which holds one classic storage account. And here I have a resource group with a classic VM and a cloud service in it. So I created a PowerShell script to migrate those things. And one of the first things that are required is the subscription. The subscription name of the subscription where the classic resources are living in. We can find that subscription name in the Azure portal, of course. Look, it's over here. Well, let's copy it and paste it in our script. What the script is basically doing, it's first logging into ARM. It's registering a resource provider that will help us to do the migration. And after that, we are going to log into the Azure ASM PowerShell module. And from there, we are going to start a migration. So first, let's log into Azure. Select the subscription which we want to use, that we have defined earlier in a variable. Register the resource provider that will help us to migrate those ASM resources to ARM resources. Now log into the Azure Service Manager with PowerShell. Also select the right subscription for the Azure Service Manager PowerShell module. Export the virtual network configuration of Azure Classic Networks. It's now over here. Let's open this with Notepad. And what you see is that the name here, virtual network site, that the name is different than in the Azure portal. And we actually need this name over here to start the migration. So let's copy that one and let's paste it in our script. So let's set the variable VNet. Okay. And we're first going to start the validation. And we will save that in a variable validation message. And what you will see in this variable, there is a message which actually always says that validation has failed. But when we check the messages that are in there, everything is liable for migration. Well, the next thing, now we have validated our virtual network, our virtual machines. The next thing is that we have to prepare for the migration, and we use a command line also for that. Move Azure Virtual Network prepare. And of course, we have to enter the virtual network name over there. Let's run this command line. This will actually take a couple of times, so let's grab a cup of coffee and we'll watch it after it's finished. So now that the migration has been finished and we have enjoyed our cup of coffee, let's have a look in the Azure portal. What you see when you look at the Azure portal is that there are a couple of migrated resource groups over there. We have a migrated resource group for the VNet and we have a migrated resource group for the VM. One of the silly things when you look at the virtual network name, as I showed you, this is actually a strange name when you created your virtual network via the ARM portal, the Ibiza portal. That name is actually used to create that that resource group. But we can migrate virtual network to another resource group later on. So we have a resource group where our virtual network is living in. Look, here it is. Here's the virtual network. And we have a resource group where the virtual machine is living in, with a couple of components that are used by the virtual machine. And when we look over there, we have a key vault, we have a load balancer, we have a public IP address, the virtual machine itself, and the network interface. The public IP address that's used for the load balancer is actually the same as that has been used in the ASM world for the cloud service. So your IP address won't change. That's actually quite a good thing. So if you're happy with the results in the Azure portal, it's time to commit the migration. And we do that by running move Azure Virtual Network with the commit parameter. Let's do that. And this one actually is going much faster than the preparation. So now that the migration has been completed, let's have a look in the Azure portal. And we will see that the classic VM is not there anymore. The resource group is still there, but the resources inside there that were classic are migrated to the new created resource group. Also, when we look at the virtual network, we will see that the resource group is empty. Now let's have a look at the resource group where the storage account is living. And as you will see, the storage account is still there. The storage account migration is done via a separate PowerShell commandlet. And that commandlet actually works the same as the Azure Move Virtual Network commandlet. The commandlet is called Azure Move Storage Account, and it also has a preparation phase, a validation phase, and of course the commit phase. Let's run that command right now. So, to start the validation, we first need the name of the storage account. And we can find that, of course, in the Azure portal. Just click on the storage account. We have the name over here. Copy that one into the PowerShell commandlets. There it is. So, let's run that commandlet over right now. Just like the Move Azure Virtual Network commandlet, PowerShell always tells us that the validation has been filled. And when we check the validation messages, we will see that there is actually no problem. So we can continue in the preparation phase. And this one will actually take a couple of minutes. Let's wait for it till it's complete. Okay, so the preparation has been succeeded. When we look in the Azure portal, we see that for the storage also a resource group has been created. Within that resource group, we will find an ARM storage account. So if you're happy with the results, it's time to commit this migration. And just like Move Azure Virtual Network with the commit parameter, this one is also deleting the classic storage account and make sure that everything is routed to the new ARM storage account. So the migration has been completed. All the old classic VMs, virtual networks, storage accounts have been migrated to new ARM resources. So with that, it's time to end this Azure vlog. If you found this interesting, please hit the thumbs up button. and also subscribe to this channel. With that, thank you and see you in the next one.